Chandra from Do With Python Technologies. In this video, we are going to see how to work with AWS root account and different IAM users using Boto3. See, if you want to work with your AWS account, you can work in different ways, right? I mean, with privileges, I am saying, whether you want to work with root privileges or if you want to work with some IAM users privileges, yes, you are allowed to work, right? So based on the IAM user policies, you are having access to certain services. Now here, if you want to use Boto3 for your AWS root account, you can use. If you want to use Boto3 for different IAM users, yes, you can use. But the thing is, you have to know how to use them. How to use Boto3 for root account and different IAM users. Right? See guys, if you want to work with either AWS root account or any IAM user, the first thing is you need to create a session object. Generally, whenever if you start your Python with Boto3 code, the first thing is you have to create a session object. That session object is for either root account or for any IAM user. Right? See, already we know what is session or session object. Session object stores configuration information of any IAM user or root account and its selected region. Means, see, if you want to work with, suppose AWS root account, you have to provide credentials for that. If you want to work with IAM users, you are having different credentials for that. And the same way, whenever if you want to work either AWS root account or IAM users through Boto3, you need programmatic access keys. And what are programmatic access keys? Already we have seen in previous videos. Right? So based on your account, either root or IAM user, you will provide programmatic access keys to your Python script for your Boto3. So while providing them, that information will be stored in session object. Now, once if you have your session object in your hand, you can create a resource or client objects for any AWS services. Right? So you are having almost 142 services in your AWS, and which are categorized into 19 groups. So if you want to work all with these services, you have to create either resource or client object. So once if you have client or resource object, now based on your requirement, you can implement the next part in your code. Right? So now I am going to show some steps to work with AWS root account and different IAM users using Boto3. Right? Let me start that. Yes, very first step is, first, configure credentials of either AWS root account or different IAM users account on your host. Right? So you want to work with the root or different IAM users, that is secondary. First thing is just configure credentials of all users, your root account along with whatever the IAM users you want to work with Boto3. For all of them, just configure your credentials on your local host with the help of this syntax. AWS configure hyphen hyphen profile, then profile name. So here profile name is any name you can provide. Suppose you are going to work with root account, then simply take AWS root and provide the credentials for that root account. Okay, you remember that you can provide any name here. The only thing is whatever the name you are going to provide here, and after that you are going to provide credentials. That credentials are related with this name only. Okay. Now see here. First thing, I am going to configure for root account and also IAM users account. Okay. Let me open my account and get my security credentials of a root account. Now these are suppose my root account credentials. Now I need to configure them on my host. Let me take host as my local host. Let me open my terminal. And you know how to configure credentials on your host simply by running AWS configure command. If you run this AWS configure command, then after that, whatever the credentials you are providing, that will be stored with username or profile name as default. But I don't want to use default name as my profile name for root account. I want to use different name for my root account. Then at that time, you can provide simply AWS configure hyphen hyphen profile. I am taking suppose AWS root. This name is your wish, guys. You can take any name here. Remember that. Suppose whatever the credentials you are going to provide here, now that credentials will be selected if you take profile name as AWS root. That's it. Okay. Now I'm going to copy and paste my credentials here. Then secret access key. Okay. Then default region name. If you want to mention, you can mention. So I'm mentioning. And JSON output I'm mentioning. That's it. Now, in your program, if you want to work with the AWS root account, credentials are these two are root account credentials. Now, for these credentials, what the profile name you have given? AWS root account. Remember that. If you want to work with root account in your program using Boto 3, now you have to select profile name as AWS root. Now, same way, I want to work with different IAM users. Okay. Let me go with my one of the IAM user. S3 user I'm selecting. Now observe here. Yeah, create access keys. Guys, actually my user is S3 underscore user. I can take same username while configuring my profile. I can take different as well. Let me take. If you want to take same IAM username, you can take here. But if you want to take different, I am taking IAM S3 user. No problem. Just profile name this is. Now I am passing access keys for them. Now if you want to select any region, you can select. Again, I'm going to take same region only. Then that's it. Now, once if you configure information like this, just go to your home directory. Already I am there in home path. Just go to .aws directory and here see what is the content is there in your credentials. Now profile name, one is AWS root and one more is IAM S3 user. Okay. So based on this credentials, your program will work. But to select this credentials, you need to select profile name as this one. Or to work with these credentials, anyway, they are root account. Now in your program, you need to select profile name as this one. So names are optional. You can take any, not optional. You can take any name. Right. That's it. Now let me open my continuation of this. Now we configured just now profile names. One is for root account. One more is for some IAM user. The next thing is, now you have to create a session object for your required either root or IAM user as follows. That's it. So session equals to boto3.session profile name. You have to select now here profile name. Suppose if I want to work with root account. So with what profile name I passed my credentials of root account, AWS underscore root, that profile name you have to provide here. Right. So in case if you don't want to work with the default region name, then you can select your region name here. Right. So first let me create session object. Let me go with my so here I'm using PyCharm. So working with different users. Suppose initially I'm going to work with the root account. Then first thing you need to import Boto3. Right, then you have to create session object. Now session, you can take any variable again. No need to take simply a straightforward session. You can take any variable here, my session, your session, or root account session, whatever it may be. So I am taking suppose root session or session for root account equals to boto3.session. Then profile name equals to, I think I have given profile name as AWS root. That's it. Okay. Then what is the next step? Now create a resource or client object for any service, but here I am going to create for S3. So if you want to work with any service, now you have to create either resource or client object based on your required service. But here, suppose I'm going to take example as S3. Nothing is there. S3 resource object is nothing but whatever the session you got here, from that dot resource your service name. Same way client, this thing. Okay, just let me create them. Now I'm going to create S3 resource object. So simply session of root, then resource, whatever the service you need, that service name. That's it. So after these things, what based on your requirement, you have to implement your code. But these three things are very, very important whenever if you want to work with any IAM user or root account. What are they? First, to configure credentials of either root account or any IAM users by using AWS configure command with the help of profile names. After that, just to create a session. That session may be for any of your profile name or any AWS or root, any AWS IAM user or root account. So that you can do by selecting profile name here. Then after that, create your resource or client object for any AWS service. Right? That's it. Now suppose I need to list out as we follows, I need to list out buckets of this S3 resource. Let me print. Let me take for each bucket in S3 resource dot buckets dot all. I want to simply print all bucket names dot name. That's it. Let me run this. See, you're getting all your bucket names. That's it. Okay. Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video.